So we're gonna just start facing the wall, and I'm gonna put my gecko paw on the wall. And the emphasis here is that I don't let part of the gecko paw come off the wall like this. I really wanna get all the surface area of my hand on the wall. I'm gonna let my shoulder drop, and from your side, it looks like I don't want it riding high. I want it here, and I want a nice wide gecko paw. Okay, first I'm just facing. I don't want excessive tension in my shoulder. I just want, yeah, just like that. Okay, good. And now my elbow is gonna twist clockwise and counterclockwise. Boom, boom. And I notice on this side, this finger wants to come up. Try to keep it down. And I'm just twisting. I'm just wringing out the sponge. Okay? With this hand. And then moving right along, I can change angles. You're gonna notice certain angles are gonna be more difficult than others. And again, I'm just twisting my wrist bones in and out. And again, this part of my palm is coming up a little bit, so I gotta focus on keeping that down. Even if I don't go as far with my elbow, I'm just wringing the sponge out. I can try this angle too. This one's really tricky. Okay, and then moving right along, now I'm gonna open. I'm gonna change where my chest is facing relative to the arm. And from here, same deal. Twisting the arm. And now I'm integrating more shoulder. And this is really letting my whole brachial plexus, letting the nerves actually floss within the fascia, which is very exciting. I can feel the nerves in my elbow, as well as the nerves as they come up here. Now, okay, so I went from my elbow, my hand to my wrist to my shoulder, and now I'm gonna go ahead and involve my neck, so I can look away and do this. And yeah, and now this is getting very interesting. I can really feel all the nerves involved with this. Boom. And just when you thought it was super exciting, it gets more interesting because now I can involve the movement of my thorax. So I can actually go this way and this way. Okay, that was gecko paw.